What's up, everybody? Justin DeLay from Reverb.com here. Today we're going to take a look at something simple but crucially important to setting up your Ableton rig, which is setting up an audio interface so that you can both record input signals into Ableton as well as get audio signals out. So let's just quickly review. We've got a laptop running Ableton. This is an audio interface. This happens to be a hybrid mixer plus audio interface, which if you're just getting into this stuff, I would highly recommend. Really affordable. You can see here plugged into a USB jack on my laptop. Pretty straightforward. Plug the USB in to the computer, and then we're ready to set up Ableton. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to the preferences in Ableton, and we're gonna look for, in the audio tab, we're gonna change the setting for the audio input device and the audio output device. So obviously, we're gonna select our mixer here as the audio input device, and again, select it as the audio output device. Now, optionally, we can go in and configure the inputs and the outputs. And what this allows you to do, so you can see here, we're gonna have it so that you can address both input one and two either individually. So if you were gonna record two different things at the same time, you could have one being recorded on input one, one recorded on input two, as well as the ability to record both one and two together in stereo. So if, for instance, you're recording like a stereo keyboard. It's already set up like that by default, so you don't necessarily have to worry about it. Again, same thing for the outputs, individual outputs or a stereo pair. And that's really the gist. Now, one cool little thing that's built into Ableton is there's actually a little test tone, so you can test that it's actually working. So what we have here is we have the left and right output from the mixer and the audio interface going to our speakers, and we're just gonna play a quick little test tone to make sure that it's working. We can hear it working. And we're good to go. And to listen to something a little bit more cool maybe than a sine wave, let's take a listen to this little rock drum loop just to make sure everything's working. And there you have it. Audio in and audio out from an audio interface into Ableton Live. Thanks.